As Uganda prepares to join the rest of the world to commemorate the World Environment Day, celebrated every year on the 5th of June, the Vision Group has today launched the Stop Plastic Pollution campaign aimed at sensitizing the masses on the need to protect the environment. The campaign particularly discourages Ugandans on poor disposal of plastic waste. During the campaign, messages on environment protection will be passed on through the various platforms of the Vision Group.
Vision Group launched the Stop Plastics Pollution campaign. Plastics are becoming a big catastrophe in our country, the way we are disposing them. It is very clear that from the pictures we are gathering from across the country, that it's a big problem in the cities, in the trading centers, but also in the villages. One of the most shocking pictures we've seen has been around Lake Victoria and around the rivers, like the River Rizzi in Mbarara. We've got very shocking pictures. And for us from the media, that made us think, well, we just have to ring a bell. We have to raise an alert and say, look, there is a big problem here. We need to do something about it as a country. So that's today. Vision Group has launched the Stop Plastics campaign, and it will run on all our platforms. It will run on the New Vision newspaper, on Bukede newspaper, Bukede TV, Bukede Radio, TV West, and on Etop. Etop Radio, Rupin Radio, Wanluo TV, TV East, Arua One. It will run on all our platforms and on our websites, our social media handles. And basically what we are trying to do is just to alert Ugandans to the danger of the problem, but also to the fact that everybody has a role to play in fighting this.
According to Kaija, plastics are not only dangerous to the environment, but also affect human health, aquatic life, and other things. A recent study examining Lake Victoria's water quality revealed that the lake has been heavily polluted with plastics, and this has also been traced in the fish obtained from the lake. This, coupled with the use of plastic bags, cavera, in the preparation of foods, has made the situation worse.
Victoria University made a study, and they've said that they are finding that our fish have got plastic in it. Like when you get 100 kilograms of fish from Lake Victoria, 20 of them have got plastic in it, microplastics in it, which is a big problem. If you're finding microplastics in the fish that we are removing from Lake Victoria or from our other lakes, it means it's ending up in our bodies, and that is one of the causes of cancer. So we really have to be careful about how we are using the plastic, but also the plastic kills the soil and it kills the water. So if we want our generations to live like we found Uganda beautiful, the pearl of Africa, we plant our food and we eat our food. If we want to leave that bequeath that to our generations, then we must make sure that we use our environment responsibly.
The Stop Plastic Pollution campaign will now focus on teaching Ugandans on the dangers of plastics, as well as engaging the plastic manufacturers on plastic recycling as a way of managing its disposal. Kaija condemned the indiscipline, especially among the motorists who throw plastic bottles through car windows.
What we want to achieve eventually is, one, we want Uganda to be aware to the danger. We want a habit change. And habit change takes a long time, so we are calling on all Ugandans to see this as important, to know that it is because we want to leave a posterity for our children, and because we want to do that, we are going to be responsible, we are going to talk about the problem, and we are going to jointly tackle it. We also hope that we can get the policymakers, including NEMA, to enforce some of the international protocols on the use and recycling of plastics.
Those involved in plastic collection and recycling will also be appreciated. The public has been urged to embrace this campaign to mitigate pollution and environmental degradation.